Hello everyone, this is Chris from Spoon Graphics. Welcome back to another video tutorial. Today we're going to play around in Illustrator to produce a retro style circular emblem, which are really popular as trendy logos or as little call to action style badges like a satisfaction guarantee or seal of approval. The design I'll be using in this tutorial is for the totally fictional powerhouse gym, although I wouldn't be surprised if there was a gym chain somewhere in the world with this same name. It makes use of many of the traits of a retro style logo, such as the alternating black and white rings and the little details like the all important stars. One of the most popular examples of this style is the Converse All-Stars logo, but you can find lots of inspiration for your design around the web. So begin by creating a new document in Adobe Illustrator. Because we're dealing in vectors, the size of the document doesn't matter too much, but I like to go to View and Hide Artboard to give myself a nice large area to work with. Select the ellipse tool and set the fill color to black with no stroke, then hold down Shift and draw the main circle of your logo or badge. Press Command and C to copy, then Command and F to paste in front. Scale this shape down a small amount towards the center by holding Alt and Shift, then clear out the black fill and give it a white stroke. Increase this stroke to around 5 points to produce a little ring. Press Command and F again to paste in another circle. Scale this shape down further towards the center, remembering to hold those Shift and Alt keys, then give this shape a white fill. Paste in another circle, this time keep the black fill and scale it down to produce a thick white ring in the middle of the emblem. Paste in yet another circle, then switch the black fill for a stroke. Increase the stroke weight to 2 points, then carefully scale this shape down to fit just inside the white ring to form a little stripe. Copy and paste this thin black ring and reposition it towards the inside of the white ring. Press Command and F to paste in another copy of the thin black ring. Scale this one so it fits perfectly in the center of the white ring. Bring up the stroke panel and check the dashed line option. Enter 0 for the dash setting, then 17 point for the gap. Select the round cap option, then increase the stroke weight to around 4 point to produce a series of equally spaced dots. One optional step here is to add some detail to the outline of the badge. Select the main black circle, then go to Effect, Distort and Transform, Zigzag. Select the smooth points option, then adjust the settings to around 1 pixel size and 20 ridges per segment, although these figures might vary depending on the scale of your document. Next we'll create a little dumbbell icon for the center of our gym logo. So using some empty space on the artboard, draw a thin shape with the rounded rectangle tool. Before releasing the mouse, use the keyboard cursor keys to adjust the radius of the corners. Draw two more rounded rectangles that are slightly larger in size to represent the heavier weight plates, then use a normal rectangle to represent the handle. Select the existing dumbbell shapes and copy and paste them to make a duplicate. Rotate them by 180 degrees, then position them on the opposite side. Open up the Align panel, then select all the shapes that make up the dumbbell. Firstly, align them using the vertical align center button, then click the horizontal distribute space button to create even gaps between all the shapes. Group all the dumbbell shapes together, give them a white fill and scale them to fit inside the center of the logo. Hold Shift and click on one of the logo circles to add it to the selection, then give it another click to make it the key object. Then use the align panel to make sure the dumbbell sits perfectly central in the logo. Make a new duplicate of one of the existing circles and scale it to fit within the main black ring. Clear out the fill and stroke, then select the Type on a Path tool from under the Type Tools menu. Click on this new circle to activate the Type on a Path tool and enter the main wording for your logo or emblem, which in my example is Powerhouse Gym. Align the text centrally, then use the Direct Selection tool to alter the start and end markers in order to position the wording evenly in the layout. Alter the tracking of the wording by selecting 100 from the drop-down menu in the character window, then increase the font size of the text so it fits within the logo. make any final adjustments to the scale of the circle in order to align it within the emblem layout. Copy and paste this type on a past circle and change its wording to a tagline such as "Reach Your Potential." Bring down the font size and use the direct selection tool to grab and move the center handle so the text flows along the bottom of the circle. Currently the text sits on the inside of the circle, so go to Type, Type on a Path, and then Type on a Path options, then change the Align to Path option to Ascender. Make any necessary scale adjustments to line the text up with the emblem layout. Use the star tool to draw a tiny star to fill in the gap between the two groups of text, then hold the Alt and Shift keys while dragging out a duplicate of this shape for the opposite side. Group these two star shapes together, then add one of the logo circles to the selection. Give this circle an extra click to make it the key object, then align the star centrally using the Align panel. The main logo is now complete, but any retro style design always needs a little distressing with some textures. Download and open one of my vector dust and scratches textures in Illustrator, copy one of the textures to the clipboard, then switch back to the emblem document. Select all the objects that make up the emblem, then press Command and G to group them together. Under the transparency panel, click the Make Mask button, then click on the right hand thumbnail which activates the mask mode. Paste in the vector texture, scale it to size, and make sure it has a black fill. Check that the clip and invert mask settings aren't checked, and then click on the artwork thumbnail from within the transparency panel to exit out of mask mode. This masking technique is a great way to add aged and weathered effects to your vector art without permanently altering the basic design, unlike using the Pathfinder. So there we have our finished retro style vector badge. I hope you found this tutorial useful and find some great uses for these kinds of badges or emblems for your future designs. If you enjoyed this video, it'd be great if you could add a like on YouTube or help spread the word by sharing it with your friends on Twitter or Facebook. If you want to see more of my content, be sure to visit my website at spoon.graphics, or you can subscribe directly to my channel on YouTube to be the first to see my upcoming video tutorials before they're released on my main site. You can also subscribe to my mailing list if you want to receive some free goodies and have notifications of all my new content land directly in your email inbox. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.